Welcome to FluidSIM video tutorials. Reports are the topic of this video. These are the topics: using reports, inserting reports, properties of reports, templates for reports, part lists, terminal diagrams, wiring lists, tube lists, cable, directories, design of the technical documentation. Using reports. The result of in report is always a table with values of the properties of the selected objects. The content of the reports are the objects such as components, connecting lines, cables, terminal blocks and terminals that are displayed on the sheets of a project. The project magazine has been expanded with additional pages so that the various report options in FluidSIM 6 can be demonstrated. The pneumatic circuit diagram includes a double-acting cylinder controlled by a monostable 5-2-way solenoid valve. The electrical circuit diagram includes the control, operating elements, sensors and actuators. In this video, the reports for these two circuit diagrams are shown on separate sheets in the project. This results in comprehensive technical documentation that can also be exported as a PDF. Inserting reports. In the Insert menu, you can use the Report button to select the template for in report. All templates appear as they were organized in the Template Manager. In the example, the item single position parts list from the FluidSIM standard templates is to be used. The mouse pointer changes to a crosshair marking the position of the upper left corner of the report. The report can be inserted on the sheet of the circuit diagram or on a separate sheet in the project. In the example, a separate sheet is used for the single item parts list. If you click on the drawing area with the left mouse button, the properties of the single item parts list dialog appears. The option to include selected files is selected on the object selection tab. The desired circuit diagrams are marked and confirmed with OK. Now the single item parts list appears according to the template and lists all the main components of the circuit diagrams. Properties of reports. Double-clicking on the report opens the properties dialog. The appearance of the report can be changed on four tabs: object selection, column selection, appearance and drawing properties. With the Edit Details button, the selection of the objects can be defined in even more detail. In the Input field, Layer, reports can also be moved to other layers. If the selected layout is to be used more than once, it can be saved with the Save as New Template button. Templates for reports. The template management also organizes the templates of the reports. If the standard templates do not meet the user's expectations, he can create user-defined templates and organize them in the template management. If, for example, an item parts list was added based on a template, this can be changed via the properties dialog and then saved as a new template. Copies of the default template can be created and edited independently of a project. The custom templates are stored in the default user-defined reports directory. Parts lists. FluidSIM differentiates between item and accumulated parts lists. A user-specific template version 01 has already been created from the standard template for the item parts lists. The template contains modified display settings and a different column selection. Some columns have been hidden and the order changed. The part numbers have been entered into the properties of the circuit diagram objects. Missing entries can also be entered in the parts list. A click with the right mouse button on the parts list opens a context menu. With the command Edit and a left click in the desired cell, its content can be overwritten. The changes are then also adopted in the objects of the circuit diagram. In the example, the designation of the compressed air source GQ1 is added. The designation can now also be displayed in the pneumatic circuit diagram. The summary parts list is now inserted. In the standard template, all objects of both circuit diagrams are combined in one position with 19 pieces. If all objects of the same type are to be totaled, a user-defined template must be created. Similar objects can be found via the description, for example. In the column selection, only objects with the same description are grouped and the number of pieces totaled. The modified template provides a summary parts list that sums up all objects of the same type. Terminal diagrams. A terminal diagram assumes that terminals have been installed in the electrical circuit diagram. In FluidSIM 6, this is done manually in order to meet the different requirements in the learning process. Terminals are assigned to a terminal strip in the background of the database. When setting the first terminal, the terminal strip must first be specified. After setting the terminals, the direction of the terminals is adjusted so that the arrow points in the direction of the internal target. If all terminals are in the circuit diagram, the terminal diagram can be inserted as in report. Like all other reports, the terminal diagram is inserted in the Insert menu using the Reports button. The compact representation was inserted first. In comparison, the detailed presentation below is now being added. The FluidSIM manual provides more information on setting the terminals and designing the terminal diagrams. Wiring lists. The wiring list provides an overview of the electrical connections in the project. Electrical connections are the wiring lines in the control cabinet and the cables that connect the control cabinet to the sensors and actuators installed outside. Wires in the electrical circuit diagram are not automatically included in the wiring list. In the electrical circuit diagram, the properties of each line must be set. The line must be labeled and the checkmark, object display in tube lists, must be set. Cables must be identified by the cable icon in the insert menu. The cable is created and described in more detail in the properties of the cable symbol. If all cables and lines are marked in the electrical circuit diagram, the wiring list can be inserted. The design of the wiring list can be adjusted in the properties and the new view can be saved as a template. Tube lists. The contents of the tube lists require the properties of lines to be set in the pneumatic circuit diagram. The line must be labeled and the checkmark, object display in tube lists, must be set. The standard templates contain a compact and a detailed tube list template. The detailed report provides additional information with manufacturer information on the tubes used. Cable. The labeling of the cables in the electrical circuit diagram is also required in the various reports of the cables. The standard templates are cable lists with one or more lines, in which all cables of the project are listed. The multi-line cable list is first inserted here. For comparison, the compact form is inserted just below, listing each cable in just one line. A cable plan can be inserted for each cable. The desired cable must be selected in the Properties dialog before it is inserted. The cable plan describes the start and destination of each core of the cable. The design can be changed at any time in the properties of the cable lists and also saved as a new template. Directories. The standard templates provide reports for the table of contents, the connector list and the object list. The table of contents is inserted on page 1 of the example project. For comparison, the same table of contents is inserted using a custom template. Here it is mainly the display properties that have been changed in the template. The row borders have been removed and row colors changed. The description was added to the column selection. This adopts the names of the folders in the project list, which can be viewed like a chapter heading. In addition to the table of contents, the connectors and object lists are also available as standard templates. The connectors list is limited to the pneumatic circuit diagram. connections only appear if they have been identified in the pneumatic circuit diagram. In the case of components such as cylinders or compressed air sources, the connections in the component library have not been designated and must now be supplemented in the pneumatic circuit diagram. Once this has been done, the connections are also visible in the connectors list. All objects and connections of a circuit diagram appear in the object list. If undefined designations that are identified by leading question marks are to be found in the circuit diagram, you can right-click on them in the object list and select the Go to Target command. The object is now displayed in the associated circuit diagram. The designation can be changed in the circuit diagram or in the object list. Right-clicking on the designation in the object list and the command, Edit, allows adding the correct designation. In this case, the silences are designated RP1 and RP2. Design of the technical documentation. All sheets of a project are arranged in the project management. For a better overview, folders have been added that divide the project folder into chapters. If you export the project to a PDF file, you get complete technical documentation. Learners can use FluidSIM alone to document complete examination projects or assignments. Thank you for your attention.